is now officially fall, which is my second favorite season apart from summer. Summer is my favorite because I really like the heat, and also the summer crops are really tasty. But fall time is a whole different ball game. Temperatures are still kind of warm, but they're actually starting to drop down to where you need like a sweater all the time. Fall time, you're actually, the flavors of the vegetables change. Like radishes go from spicy to like sweet and crispy, and the carrots get a lot sweeter, the parsnips, everything starts to like sweeten up, and because the carbohydrates change the sugars so that the vegetables can withstand colder temperatures. But there's also a whole slew of new vegetables available during the fall time. We just dug some potatoes at the other property, as well as we got some celery root right over here.
All right, so we're gonna pick, start to pass the green there. These first four rows are the blue hopi, but unfortunately the coons ate almost all of them. So you're gonna pick them, peel them back, try to keep them like this because we'll tie them up like that. So actually maybe go into your boxes and you want to transfer them twice. Lay them in the old way.
The what ate all of them?
What's that?
The what ate all of them?
Raccoons.
Oh.
I never had that with the dry corn before. I think the raccoons were so hungry for some reason this year. So, try to push them down because we want to leave this on here, or else when you peel this back, you'll lose the husks. If the husks do break off, go ahead and just throw it in your box and we'll separate them out later. Nope. There's nothing at all.
Oh. Dakota black popcorn?
Dakota black, they're supposed to be about that long. But a lot of them, there's just nothing there at all. They're probably going to get hardly anything. They like aborted their ears for some reason. It's really weird.
Dang, harvesting this corn was really tough. It really bothered me because there's so many weeds in there. There's so much pollen going on. Walking through there is incredibly difficult. And also the raccoons came through, ate a lot of the corn. The heads are really small and puny. I'm gonna take great pleasure in mowing this down right now and just like being done with this.
I'm trying to leave them as long as I can. So anything like this one, it's just this other thing is holding it up there. Go ahead and cut those, and we'll cut them about not that long so we can tie them up like we did the other time.
Mm-hmm.
Getting to be a pretty dry stem. It's not looking like it's going to stay out much longer. Go ahead and cut those.
We just hung the sunflowers in here so they can dry a little bit more before we pick them out of the shells, and just trying to let them cure.
First and then
okay, we're just like scraping off the dirt and the root balls.
Yeah, so trying to get all those hairies off and the and these things at the very end, slap those things off.
Mm-hmm.
You can help me bunch these up. I think there was a light on there. Smudge right there. So it's just the one row here. Let's call this, that's your minimum size. So try not to pull anything smaller than that. If you do, go ahead and use it. Kind of bang that dirt off a little bit like that. If you cut higher, then if you cut like above where these break off, so if we were to cut above there, so you can already actually see that leaf. See right there? That's a new leaf that's going to grow. So if we cut above that, we're going to get all that stuff to grow out during storage. It's probably not so important right now because these aren't going to be stored very long. But if we were going to put them into storage like that, we'd have all kinds of greens to come out.
Vera,
I mean, if I want more, I'll give you another place to go. Get your knife.
It definitely looks cold out here today. Not all
yeah, it looks colder than it is.
This is beautiful. Same color as your shirt too.
This variety is actually called Scarlet Stem.
Scarlet Stem.
It's a Japanese one. Alright. So first thing, make sure you're not stepping on the leaves. Like right here, I'm stepping on that leaf. And you'll pull and pull and won't come out. So make sure you're not stepping on the leaves. And then actually the ground's soft enough that these should be pretty easy to pull, but when the ground's not soft, I stick my finger as deep as I can go down in there and break any side roots that might be on there. Yep, I found some side shoots. And then I stick my finger way down as deep as I can go. And then slowly, gradually, if they jerk them, they break. It's a slow, gradual pull. Yeah, see now it's actually wet all the way to the root for the first time since the whole season. So they come up a lot better. A lot easier. And that's how you pull daikon.
Man, those are good size too.
Yep.
They're really good size. This is my hand.
I'm getting there. Look at that turnip.
Oh my god. That's bigger than a softball.
There's hiding out amongst the leaves. The first week they didn't so very good, and I think it's because I might have you skip over the biggest ones. And actually, they're getting really loose now, so you really got to be careful.
They're delicious, though.
What am I going to do with the greens? I want a lot of them pinched out, though, because I don't want to have a lot of... Before frost, we need to harvest. The main big job before frost is going to be harvest out all the peppers. Unless that frost hangs off for a really long time, we'll still have a lot of peppers in the field. So we'll harvest those all out. Anything that's ripe or close to ripe, we'll harvest. Everything's, we can store them for 2 or 3 weeks without them getting soft. If there's tomatoes left at that point, you know, all the tomatoes that are anywhere close to ripe. We have any green beans left, we'll harvest those out. Okra, harvest those out. These are all things that'll be wiped out even by a light frost. But sometimes peppers will make it through a really light frost with just some damage to the leaves. But since a lot of our fruit is already exposed, we probably need to get all this green out even if it's a light frost. So that's before a frost. And then, like I was saying, either before or right after, we need to do another set of jobs. The main one being digging the sweet potatoes. And then we start getting into regular frost and start getting into the hard freezes where it's going below 32. And then we have kind of a progression of jobs getting roots out of the ground. So all our roots that are down in the ground right now are all frost tolerant, but they're not, and they're even somewhat freeze tolerant, but if they get frozen, they don't store as well. But most sensitive things are the fall radish. Pretty much the farther they stick out of the ground, the sooner you gotta harvest them. So like daikon, sticking way out of the ground, has to be taken first. And then the purple radish, black radish, all those things. They're kind of the most sensitive. And after that, Japanese turnips, followed by the fall turnips, purple tops and golden's, rutabagas are about next. Celery root. Beets. So this is kind of one group in that order. And then the things that are pretty much all the way in the ground, like carrots, they don't really stick up out of the ground. Parsnips. Sunjokes. So these two, the potatoes and the carrots, as long as we get them out before the ground freezes, we're fine. Unless the carrots are sticking up out of the ground. So all this stuff is first, then these two things before the ground freezes. And then the parsnips and the sunchokes, we can actually leave in the ground all winter. They can survive in the frozen ground.